great honor to introduce this week's convocation speaker. A number of years ago, we established the tradition of inviting an alumnus back to speak to the incoming students, and that tradition has proven to be very, very meaningful over the years. Our convocation speaker this year is Mr. Peschong. He's a 2012 graduate of SMSU. During his time here, he participated in a variety of activities, including football, basketball, the SMSU Marketing Club, and ACTUS, and several others. Upon graduation, he began working in the leasing industry with Hampton Ridge Financial. He then transitioned into an opportunity as an agent escrow with State Farm Insurance, and in the spring, that was in the spring of 2013. It's a role that he currently has today, but he's taking steps in the very near future to have his own State Farm agency, probably within the next 18 months or so. So if any of you are looking for internship opportunities in the future, get your resumes ready. Tyler's inbox is on, but it will be very soon. Outside of his career with State Farm, Tyler is a very active writer and speaker. He has the goal of helping people of all ages, regardless of where they come from, develop strategies to achieve their goals and dreams. And I really am really honored to introduce Tyler. He was in two of my classes, and so I'm really looking forward to what he has to say. I'm sure he has some great things to say to all of you. Please join me in welcoming back to SMSU, Mr. Tyler Peschong.
Because these answers aren't for you. But if you want to lead, you want to innovate, if you want to make a difference in your time here, then listen up. I'm going to give you some answers. Number one, the first thing you have to do is focus every day on your why. Unless you know your why, it is really tough to grow. I learned this from a man named Simon Sinek. Sinek speaks eloquently about the importance of knowing your why. Easier put, why are you here? An answer I would have given at 18, and probably the answer that a lot of you guys would give me is, I don't know, I'm here to get a college degree, I guess, or get a job. Same thing I would say. Except that would be what you were doing, not why you are doing it. Your why is your passion. For me, my why is to make a difference in every single life that I meet. It's what drives me every day. It's why I'm standing here this morning. It's why I chose SMSU, and it's why I work for State Farm. Because all three of those provide an outlet for me to make a difference in people's lives when they need or needed help. I'm speaking to a group of people this morning full of nervous anxiety over the next 4 or 5 years, and we hope to provide some answers for you. I chose SMSU back in 2008 because it's an opportunity for me to further my education. Make no mistakes about it, it was an opportunity for me to play football. Back then, guys, football guys, it was not the program that it is today. I wanted to make a difference in a program that truly needed growth. It was my why. For 5 years as a college athlete, for not for one practice, not one game, not one workout, was I the best player on my team. But I showed up. I brought contagious energy. I helped create a culture that now with better players and improved players, none better than your current quarterback, a good friend of mine, Blake Gibble, who you all need to go out and watch because he's unbelievable and only has 1 year left. The sky is the limit for that program. I chose a career with State Farm that allowed me to see people after the worst. A car accident, a house fire, the death of a family member. Provide a light during that time and try to make a difference. It is my why. What is your why? What above all else truly motivates you? If you can figure out the answer to that question, I promise you, you won't get snoozy. You'll be up, ready to chase your dreams. Stand up again real quick. Look at that person next to you again. Say, why is this guy still talking? Number two, if you increase your network, you will increase your network. It is single-handedly the best advice I've ever heard. Jeffrey Dinnemer says it best when he says it's not about who you know. It's about who knows you. One of the biggest pet peeves I get talking with our generation, I know I'm an old man, but it makes me feel better saying our generation, so just go with it, is that it's impossible to find a job. My thought is simply this. You just spent 4 or 5 years at a networking event and you can't find a job? Who's all looking for you? You see, I go to networking events all the time in my career. College is no different. The most important thing a person does at a networking event is show up. It's really hard to network with your professors and peers when you skip your last 4 classes. The next thing a person does at a networking event is they engage other people. They strike up conversation, they get to know each other, and eventually they talk about business. But a lot of people get themselves in trouble at these events because they spend a lot of time talking about themselves. The fact of the matter is, you and I both know we don't like the person that spends a lot of time talking about themselves. We love the person that spends a lot of time helping other people. And the simple reality is this. People will go to bathroom and try to help you in a time of need. Like when you're trying to find a job after college. If, and only if, they like you. And some of the people in the crowd right now are saying, how the heck do I get someone to like you? The answer is very simple. When you think back to elementary school, it's a lot easier for me than a lot of me and people sitting in the chairs here in the defense of elementary school. Who were your best friends at that time, and why? The people you're thinking about right now are the people who actively engaged you, who played with you, who had fun with you. The same applies today. Successful people want to be around people who are engaging, full of life, and constantly push the status quo forward. It's really hard to get people to like you. I'm talking all people, professors, peers, community members, subway employees. By locking yourself into a dorm room watching Shameless on Netflix for 12 straight hours. A lot of you guys chuckled or looked at me goofy when I said subway employees. But I'm standing here today, over 4.5 years into State Farm, because I struck up a conversation with a subway employee right here in Marshall that I had no idea at the time. I had a relative that oversaw multiple State Farm agencies in Minnesota. When it came time for me to get a job after college, I reached out to that guy. And it wasn't 2 weeks later that I had a job. Guys, I didn't find my first job at State Farm. Someone found it for me. Is it tough to find a job after college? By yourself, sending out a bunch of resumes, yeah, it might be. Was the team looking for you? It's not. Stand up again. Look at someone you don't know, whether it's the person next to you, whether it's someone who comes to you the day, wave at them, smile, wave. And then afterwards, I want you to talk to that person. Tell them your name and where you're from. All right, let's sit back down. What you just did right there was increasing the memory. If you do that the next 4 years, I promise you, you'll be amazed at what opportunities are ahead of you. Number three, be heard. There's a monumental difference between being heard and being loud. Some of the quietest people I've ever known were always heard through their work ethic and action. On the flip side, some of the loudest people I've ever known were never heard. Now, what do I mean by that? When I speak about being loud, I'm talking about the person that's, we all know this person, that always is talking, never listening, center of attention all the time, never ever listens to whatever anyone else is saying. You and I, me and both know that that person gets old really quick. It's tough for that person to expand their network. When I speak about being heard, I'm talking about portraying thoughts, words, and actions in a way that people listen. It's about living a life that people want to emulate. Your professors don't know who you are because they call your name out and check your name on the attendance sheet. But rather, they know exactly who you are that moment you walk into the classroom. There's a huge difference between the two. They know you because you portray a passion for understanding and growth, even if it's not your favorite subject. A lot of the professors out sitting here today, and Professor Folkman will tell you as well, they would attest to what I'm about to say next. I am 100% certain that I was never the smartest kid in any class. I'm from Central Iowa. But when my time ended at SMSU, the majority of the professors that I did have knew exactly who I was. Because I engaged them as human beings. The professors are human beings. Get to know them. And when my time ended at SMSU, I had multiple professors standing there ready to help. One professor actually took me all the way to Kansas City for a job fair for my senior year. Professors like Dr. Denise Gosher, Mike Lynch, Brent Jeffers, and multiple others are people that I consider to be teachers, mentors, but most importantly, when I left, friends. I challenge you to do the same. Be heard in the classroom and in the community. Get to know people. You won't regret it. I'm going to do something that no one in any speech class that will ever take will tell you to do. I want you to grab your phone. There's old Verizon commercials there. And I want you to put up, I don't think they have it anymore. I want you to put your phone up to your ear. A lot of you guys have been on your phone for the last 10 minutes. This should be really easy. I want you to look at me and say, can you hear me now? Good. That was really loud. That was loud. I want you to verbally say it. All right, try again. Can you hear me now? Good. Thank you. Number four. The last answer that will get you through this journey is very simple. hard, it's the hardest for multiple languages. Move. The first three answers I explained today can't and will not happen without moving. We as individuals are conditioned to be at our best when we're moving and engaging. That's why I had to move so much today. Because movement creates energy, and energy creates action. One of the biggest lies that we're all told is that you can do or have whatever you set your mind to. It's not true. You can do or have whatever you're willing to work for. And that's where the large majority of people fall short. The majority of people will hear the same message, be motivated by that message, and be so pumped, they will do absolutely nothing different. How many times has this happened in your life? You read a book, or you hear a speaker, and you go, I'm going to take the world by storm. And no more than 3 days later, you've forgotten every single thing that was said that day. I know I'm guilty. The single thing that separates the successful, the wealthy, the innovative, from the majority of the people in this country is one word: action. See, our generation more than ever has been conditioned that it's okay to not take action. We're still going to get a trophy whether we did anything to deserve it or not, even if our team loses. I'm here to tell you guys, the real world doesn't work like that. People win in the real world, and people lose. That's a fact. It's the very foundation of capitalism that was created by our founding fathers. But here's the great news. At 18 years old, you have the answers. You have to move. You have to experience the things and engage people at your time here at SMSU. Your college experience is kind of like the breakfast in the real world. It sets foundational habits for the rest of your life. These next four, in my case five, years, will set foundational habits that will help shape the rest of your life. Have one of those habits with you. Physically, spiritually, emotionally, constantly be moving. Experience clubs, groups on campus that you never thought you'd have an interest in. Intramural activities, things like that. Go to the gambling from time to time. Once you're of age, of course, don't get me in trouble. And have some fun. This time in Marshall, like your entire life in general, is way too short not to maximize the time. Take advantage of this opportunity. Figure out your why. Increase your network. Be heard. And move. The answers are there. My question is, what are you going to do with it? Welcome to SMSU Class of 2021. I cannot wait to watch you grow. Thank you.
Tell you about a really important program. I'm going to call our academic deans up to the